fair approximation, but somewhat lacking in aroma. Real cauliflower should forcibly open one's sinuses well before the first sip.
We don't have much experience in replicating Romulan beverages. Of course, all of that would change if we became allies instead of cold warriors.
You are persistent, Captain, I'll grant you that. But dogged determination isn't enough to change the reality of your situation. Time is definitely not on your side. The Dominion shipyards are operating at 100% capacity. Yours are still being rebuilt. The Dominion is breeding legions of Jem'Hadar soldiers every day. You're experiencing a manpower shortage. But most important, the Dominion is resolved to win the war at any cost. You and I both know the Federation has already put out peace feelers. Now, in all candor, if you were in my position, which side would you choose?
I'd pick the side most likely to leave us in peace when the dust settles. Maybe you're right. Maybe the Dominion will win in the end. Then the Founders will control what we now call Cardassia, the Klingon Empire, and the Federation. So, instead of facing three separate opponents with three separate agendas, you'll find yourselves facing the same opponent on every side. There's a word for that. Surrounded.
It really is a good replica. The aroma started to grow on me. For a moment there, I almost forgot it wasn't the real thing. But only for a moment. You make some very good points, Captain. But it's still all speculation and theory. Nothing that would warrant abrogating our treaty and plunging the Empire into war.
What if I told you that the Dominion is planning a sneak attack on the Romulan Empire at this very moment?
I'd want proof.